Hi everyone, Maddy here. It's that time of the year again. Time to be with friends and family, given or chosen, and especially for me, time to recharge my creative batteries.
What better way to do this than drawing something inspired by the holidays? So today, I have chosen to create this snow globe greetings card that I hope you'll design alongside me. First things first, let's set up our document to A5 portrait from the paper templates. I like to set up a base, so I am creating a dark blue background. Then I'm adding my sketch on top. So let's make sure this is set at 20% opacity. I'm actually going to start with the hands. We're going to create them from scratch using a reference photo. I have a full tutorial on how to draw hands from different perspectives, so watch that for an in-depth lowdown of the process. But for this tutorial, we're going to use a different technique. We're going to trace a reference picture. Make it personal and take a picture of your own hands holding a spherical object, or in my case, your little narwhal plush. You can also adjust the photo so it looks natural. Okay, now I'm going to trace the shape with the pen tool. Having a generous stroke width really makes this easy. Also, the fact that I round off any angular nodes after I've already drawn the general shape by using my go-to double tap gesture. Did you catch that difference? Once you get used to the pen and node tool, tracing becomes second nature, so just tap 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 away until the hands are done. I'm not going to go crazy with details here, just the fingernails will do. Next, we can select the shape and turn fill on. And fill in the rest. And I'm going to make this look twice as good with just a few minor changes. I reduced the stroke width and changed the color to that of the background. Ta-da! And to make this easier, let's just group, duplicate and mirror on the other side. Okay, now let's put the globe in to see how it looks. I think it looks pretty good. Now, let's focus on the centerpiece. As always, I like to start with a base, which I'm designing with the simple shapes that I'm manipulating with the node and selection tool. There's nothing that you can't create just by playing with basic shapes, angles, perspective, and a little bit of imagination. Thank you. When moving tiny objects like this, where every pixel matters, I am a big fan of the joystick in the corner here. Saves me a lot of time. Nothing says Christmas like a snowy day, so let's make a snowflake to adorn the base with. I'm just using the pen tool to create these angular shapes. You can use the width and height menu to input a precise number here, which I really think lends to the beauty of a snowflake's perfect structure. Duplicate a few times, rotate, and it's done. Let's add this to our base. Mirroring is a handy way to make things look symmetrical and neat. Okay, now it's time for the snow globe itself. A simple circle will do, but I'm also adding the illusion of frost with a gradient. If you're familiar with my art style, you know by now that I'm very keen on gradients. For this, we're going to create a white to transparent radial gradient. And I'm using the handles and the teardrops to achieve this frosty look. Let's move on to the macro universe inside the globe. And we're starting with, you guessed it, the base. We're drawing this little hill where our tree is growing. I've used the pen tool for that, and I'm keeping it for the tree itself. I'm just tracing each layers like a zigzag, and afterwards I'm rounding up every other node by double tapping it. If you want this to be even more round, then drag on the handles outwards, like so. For the top, it's the same process, but we're building more like a triangle shape rather than a rectangle. Alright, it's time to transform it into a Christmas tree. So let's add some cute decorations with the shape tool in different colors. And then I'm using a flat brush to make sure swirls at each level, so to speak. The star to top it all off, just use the star tool. But let's inject some magic into it. I'm adding all these swirls and curves around the tree to make it look like it fell from the sky, swooshed around the tree and landed on top. It's not a madastic illustration without some fun effects. So let's duplicate this and give it a blur. Now it's really come to life. Then let's make the bunny using simple circles. And add the shadow for death. Here, we just need to copy and paste the entire bunny shape to create the cast shadow on the ground. Move the points with the node tool if you need. And set the blending mode to multiply. I hate the idea of this bunny watching the show alone, so let's give it a partner. Last touch, the shadow of the tree. And we're done with the Christmas scene. In my eyes, this is not a card without a holiday cheer, so let's write a classic Happy Holidays in an elegant script font, like Great Vibes. And rotate the text boxes diagonally, and in this step, make sure that they're parallel to each other. Looks good! Let's make it look amazing! Add a few more stars with the blur, a shadow for the hands, and finally, a super subtle effect coming from the globe with an overlay blending mode. The moment we've been waiting for. Let's turn this beauty into a card. So, I'm going back to my document picker and select A4 this time. Why? Because we're going to divide it into two. Make sure the line is perfectly centered. On one side, you can put your own logo, name, signature, or whatever you feel says most about your brand. And on the right, I decided to create a frame that goes around the illustration. This is just a quick tip from me. If you are printing at home, your printer will not cover the edges, so I recommend adding a chunky frame. It will make the white space around the artwork intentional. So, once you've made this window-looking shape using Unite, just paste the artwork. And use the mask function. Make sure you move some of the elements so they don't get lost. and then print it. Fold it. And write your message. Merry Christmas, everyone! Wish you an amazing holiday season and a great start to the new year. I really had fun creating this for you. Always happy to hear from you guys, so say hi in the comments below. I'll see you in my next tutorial. Bye!